Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 19 of our GoLang course. In this lesson, we will cover slicing a slice or an array, also known as the slice expression. Along with it, we will also cover the built-in copy function. So let's begin. Go allows you to create a slice from an existing slice or an array using the slice expression. This also allows us to bridge the gap between an array and a slice in Go. Since you can use the slice expression to derive a slice from an array or create a slice from an array. To create a slice from a slice or an array, we use the slice expression, which is square brackets with a range of indices for the part of slice or array we want to create the new slice from, separated by a colon. If you forgot, an expression in programming is something that can be evaluated to a value. Here, a slice expression yields the slice value. Here is an example of a slice expression. In the example, we are creating a slice p from slice a and copying values from index 1 to 9. Why 9? That's because the range specified here inside the square brackets is a half open range, which includes the first element but excludes the last element or the last index, that is 10. B in the end will have values from index 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, but not 10. Let us look at some example of different slice expressions. All these expressions will work if A is either a slice or an array. In the first example, we have both the starting and the ending index, also known as the upper and the lower limit respectively. The starting index is 2 and the end index is 5. This means that the resultant value or the resultant slice will have values from index 2 up to 5. In other words, values of index 2, 3 and 4. Don't worry too much, we will look at this with our code in the next lesson. In the second example, the starting index is empty or we are not specifying the starting index, which means we want to start slicing from the first index or index 0. So we want values from index 0 up to 5, again excluding index 5. So the values copied in B would be from index 0 to index 4. In the third example, we have the starting index but have omitted the end index after the semicolon. This means we want to slice from index 3 to end of the slice, copying values from index 3 to last index. When you don't specify the ending index, it will copy everything from starting index to the end of the slice, similar to what we have here. When you don't specify the starting index, the slicing will be done from the start to the end index specified here. In the fourth example, we have omitted both the start and the end index in the slice expression. This will result in a new slice created with all the values from the source slice. So B will have all the values from A. Slice expression or slicing is useful when you want to process a range of indices from a given slice or to move values from array to a slice, but you should be very careful when slicing. Let's see why. In the lesson for slices, we covered how slices are wrappers around arrays and the slices themselves don't store data but use an underlying array to store data. This becomes tricky with slicing. When you create a new slice with the slice expression, the new slice does not get a new underlying array assigned to it but keeps using the underlying array of the source slice or the slice you created the new slice from. So what that means is both the new and the old slice will share the underlying array even after slicing. The changes made to one slice will be visible through the other slice since they refer to the same underlying array. This is why we say that manipulating or appending values into a child slice or the slice created from another slice will have ripple effect. Similarly, if you manipulate or append data to the parent slice, it will have a ripple effect on the child slice or any slices created from it. So you should be very careful when you are creating a new slice from an existing slice or an array, because manipulating any of the existing slice or the new slice will change the state of the underlying array. We will see this in our coding session, but you should take special care when working with slices created from slice expressions. To understand this in depth, let us look at an illustration. Here in the illustration, we have slice A with an underlying array assigned to it with length 5 and capacity 5. Now, we slice slice 1 and created slice 2 from it, from index 0 to 2. As mentioned earlier, please note that slice 2 will keep on sharing the underlying array of slice 1. If you manipulate data in slice 1 or 2 for index 0 to 2 which are shared between both the slices. It will be reflected in both the slices as they share the underlying array. The capacity of the new slice created after slicing is the capacity of the source slice, which is 5, minus the starting index, which is in this case 0. So the final capacity of slice 2 is 5. Now, if you append values to slice 2 using the append function sees that there is capacity available in slice 2 where values can be appended. After appending values to slice 2, you will see index 3, which the slicing algorithm sees as a free space, will be updated. If you append another value, then it will be reflected at index 4 of the underlying array shared by both slice 1 and 2. Now, if we create a slice till the end of source slice, the capacity of the new slice will be equal to the length of slice, which in this case is 4. That is because, again, if you remember, I said that the resulting slice will have a capacity of the starting index minus the overall capacity, which is 5 minus 1, 4. In this case, if you append value to slice 3, the slice data structure will see that the capacity has been reached already. So, Go will create a new array of greater length, assigning it to slice 3 and copying values from slice 3, that is 35, 4, 2, in that new array. So, at this point, slice 3 will start referring to the new underlying array created by Go. This would mean you won't see the same effect as appending to slice 2 when you append to slice 3. But in case, if before the append, you manipulate the value of existing indices in slice 3, like I do slice 3 square brackets 2 is equal to 10, that manipulation will be seen in slice 1 and slice 2, as the underlying array is still shared. There is another way of forcing Go to create a new array when you append to the new slice created from the slice expression. The slice expression accepts a third value separated by a colon, which is the capacity of the new slice. If you pass the capacity to be equal to the length of the new slice we are creating, you will get the same behavior as slice 3 in our illustration when appending to the newly created slice. That is, Go will create a new underlying array with greater size and copy values from the older array to new underlying array. So, B can be sliced from A and we want values from index 0 excluding index 10. The capacity of the new index is set to the length of the array, which is 10. This will mean if we append to B using the append function, a new underlying array is created and B will start referring to that new underlying array. Again, please note direct manipulation with the index before Go creates a new underlying array for the slice, that change will be reflected in A as well. By direct manipulation, I mean updating a value with indices. So now you have seen the problems when we are doing a slice expression or slicing an existing slice on an array. The previous example where passing a capacity solves one of the problems that when we append a new slice, a new array is created, but direct manipulation will still result in the ripple effect. There's a solution for this too. The solution is called the built-in copy function. Here is the signature of the copy function. Copy function takes the destination slice and the source slice, returning the number of elements it copied. It is globally available like len, cap, and append. The copy function will copy as many elements as it can from the source to destination slice. If the destination slice is smaller than the source slice, it will omit the excessive values. Usually, you will create a new slice of known length and then copy the values from another slice to it. Since the second argument to the copy function is a slice, you can also pass slice expression directly to copy from a slice or an array. Here are a few examples of the copy function in use. In the first example, we are copying elements from slice P to A. The first argument is a source slice where you want to copy the values to, and the second argument is the slice from which you want to copy. In the second example, we are copying a range of elements from B to A. That range is 1 to 10, or elements at index 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 to A. In the third example, B is an array. So, first we need to convert it to a slice for copy to work. How we do that is by slice expression. Since we want to copy all the values from B to A, we don't have a starting and the end index. That is how you can copy from an array to a slice. That's it for the lesson. In this lesson, we covered slice expression and then the copy function. In the next lesson, we will practice these concepts with some code. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment under the video or reach out to the Discord server. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Happy coding.